Hi, you're watching DJ TV, and next up we're testing out Serato's Video SL. It's a plugin for Serato's DJ software, Scratch Live, and adds the capability to scratch and mix video files as if you were playing with real vinyl or CDs. It previously only worked with Scratch Live if you own the expensive Rain TTM 57 SL mixer, which is one of our major gripes with version 1. They fixed this issue with the recently released All Improved Video SL 1.1 on test today. Serato have also made it possible to use MIDI controllers and MIDI-enabled DJ mixes to control Video SL in place of the TTM mixer. They've also added support for Rain's SL1 and SL3 audio interface, which makes Video SL a lot more affordable at just £189 extra. We caught up with 2007's UK DNC champion JFB in the lead up to Brighton's biggest outdoor party.
Fatboy Slim booked me and Beardy to do our first joint video scratching set.
Ladies and gentlemen of Brighton, it is now time for you all to experience the awesomeness of Fatboy Slim!
I was already sold on Serato for audio by the time the visual side came in. It took them a lot of persuading to get me to pay anything apart from vinyl. It took you and JFB really and Beardy to show me what you could do with it and show me how easy it was.
It's a complex bit of kit, but it allows you to use it in quite a basic way if that's what you want to do. If you're happy with using it in a basic way, and it's nice and stable, and it does all this stuff that we think is incredibly clever, and we only know we're using a tiny bit of it, but it really does what we want it to do. And it's really exciting that it does that. I mean, if it could trigger lasers off the
fireworks.
If you could do fireworks with that, I'm sure Norm would be quite into that.
Yeah, poor old Tim, for the first sort of 3 or 4 years, he had to just sit there and watch me and guess what I was going to play next, guess where the breakdowns happened, where the big bits is. There was a lot of sign language of me sort of counting in, going big bit, or showing him the sleeve of what I was going to play next so he could get the visuals up right. But now we kind of, Tim does it in the studio first, so we've got everything synced up with the... What's it called? Video...
Video SL.
Video SL.
Serato.
Serato bit I can remember.
Video SL, yeah.
But it was a perfect time in my career, because after the Brighton Beach Party, we got invited to do tons of things like the Rio we did on the beach, on Flamingo Beach in Rio. And just Glastonbury and things like that, the gigs were getting bigger and bigger, and we were thinking, there's only so much a DJ can do with two turntables. And the visual element was becoming more and more important in how to play, you know, an outdoor stage at Glastonbury.
Thank you.
Along with his thoughts on the new technology, we find out how VideoSL has developed in version 1.1.
We did that virtual vinyl one, the Neumark one, and that was the first vinyl controlled video scratching unit that I used, and that was wicked at the time. But the Serato one's a lot better, I must admit.
And with plenty of hardware options available from Pioneer and budget options from Neumark, what sets VideoSL apart?
I've been looking at DVJs. I was really into them. I went to Norm and went, wow, look, there's these DVJs. They're really good. You can just like, play them and it'll sync it with video at the same time. He's like, nah, not really interested. I go, it's just like a CDJ. He goes, do you see me playing CDJs? And sort of persisted for a while and then just like, no. It's like, okay, fine, but we're not going to use these. And then Serato came along with the little outboard box and we're like, oh yeah, that's quite useful.
That was the sticking point, wasn't it? It was the CD, DVD. Thing because I learned to play on vinyl and you can't teach an old dog new tricks. I've tried using CDJs and they just don't behave the same way. Because we were using Serato anyway, and then one day you went,
That's what I found.
The major advantage of a software system is that you don't need large and expensive hardware, which makes the likes of VideoSL the most portable VJing systems available. Scratch Live is the most popular digital vinyl system because of its simplicity and rock solid performance. And VideoSL walks in these well-trodden footsteps. The software can take care of the video mixing, and Serato have added some great features for controlling video transitions without any extra controllers. But the Rain TTM57SL has the Scratch Live audio interface built in. It has dedicated controls for the video software, and its faders can be linked to VideoSL's channel brightness and video crossfader.
Now you've got everything that's contained in one box. I was impressed that there was a mixer that had the whole Serato and a mixer in it, but that and video as well.
If you already own Scratch Live, regardless of what Rain interface you use, all you need to do is install the VideoSL plugin, connect a projector, and it's ready to go. Now you can load up video files to mix, scratch, and add effects to your video set. To start out, launch Scratch Live and you'll find a new video tab. We're using a MacBook Pro with an S-Video converter that costs just £15 from Apple. Hit the video tab and a video output window pops up.
So I'm picking it up, bring him over here, and then as if by magic, I can make him jump over there.
Now double click on Iggy in the small monitor.
I like this machine.
In the VideoSL tab, these three squares are your video previews. The middle one represents the master output, and the two on either side represent the two decks. Flick the full screen button here to maximize the output window. These sliders control the brightness of each deck, and there's a crossfader under the master output screen. All these faders and many other features can be controlled via MIDI or linked to the TTM mixer controls. And finally, under each deck is a pair of effect banks, and there's all the fine-tuning settings in here. Apart from the new plug-in window, the only obvious changes in Scratch Live is the new video tab, the video crate in the directory tree, and two new buttons underneath the playback deck. And Serato have even made it possible to add video to your set, even if you don't have music videos for your favourite tracks.
The video scratching Serato has got a really good thing where you can grab any tune that's playing, you can just get any video you've got on your computer and you can just load it onto the track. The only problem with that is that it's a bit random really, and you can't necessarily say it's going to be very good, you just have to hope it looks alright. So it's better to kind of pre-prepare it, I guess.
Load an audio file onto the deck and then drop videos onto this button to associate them to that tune. Now every time you load the audio file, it will call up the video as well. There are no controls for when the video starts or stops, and it keeps looping if it's shorter than the audio. Now this is far from ideal, so it's really worth putting in some effort learning some video software so you can realise all your creative ideas.
As an example, what I'd do would be get a scratch sentence, so you've got like, fresh words, say what, and then under each scratch sample, I get a little movement of video and chop that a different bit of video with movement. There's one point I got a pizza and put it on my turntable, and got this sample which goes ah, yeah, and just recorded my hand moving it going forward once for the ah and then again for the yeah bit. And so when I scratch it, it looks like you're scratching with the pizza. It's a bit silly, but it's wicked.
You can find a list of all the intricate improvements in Video SL 1.1 at scratchlive.net. But the major news is its ability to work with any audio, video and controller kit that you like.
Because that was my mixture of choice. If you, yeah, if it could do what the Rain does. Because that way I'd have the effects that I know inside out.
But you wouldn't be able to select the crates, but that could be a payoff.
Oh no. No, I wouldn't.
Quite like the crate selection.
I like the crate selection a lot, yeah.
But you've got them blocked off with that.
No, you find that's where the block off ends. It's the most important button, so we've actually got little sticky labels on them because they're my... Would you like to see?
This area, this field here is bad, bad stuff. But these two are good. That scrolls down the records, and that scrolls down the crates. And then that selects left it. So they're the buttons you can see. They're quite warm, so they get used a lot. Those two, that, and that, and the EQ obviously. But it's all this stuff here, B1 to B6. I don't know what it does.
Just click on the MIDI Learn button and the Video SL panel changes to display all the options for mapping. Click on a control, move a slider, dial or hit a button on your controller and it's set.
You can't change the video crossfader curve as opposed to the audio crossfader curve.
Serato addressed this problem in Video SL 1.1 and added contour control for the video faders and crossfader. And if you have the TTM, all controls can be linked to the mixer's contour settings here. A major advantage of using the TTM mixer or any MIDI controller is the ability to change all of Video SL's settings without touching a computer. Let's take you through the different video transitions using the TTM mixer now. So group 5 is for video, and this button, which is normally used for switching deck focus, now switches the rest of these controls between effects or fader control. Video SL comes with an overlay card which makes most of this obvious, but it still takes a lot to remember where everything is.
In the bank set buttons, you can control parts of the video scratching Serato with it, but you can't change, you can't customize that. It's like the effects in the mixer, you have to keep it the same.
Thankfully, Rain listened to feedback and DJs can now configure the controls in group 5, though only for Video SL, but you can add video controls to other groups. When you're in fader mode, either of these encoders pull up 16 different transition types for the crossfader. As well as all the basics like wipes and fades, more in-depth options are available when used with certain effects such as chroma and luminance. You can use the left joystick for momentary transform or switch over with the right joystick. You can also use the headphone cue fader as a video crossfader by hitting this button to activate it. And this button links the video crossfader with the TTM crossfader. These outer two buttons link the volume and brightness faders for each channel. Moving on to the video effects, Video SL 1.1 is double the amount on offer. Many of these take advantage of a new 8-bar graphic EQ. And if you own the TTM mixer, some of these new video effects will also work with the mixer's EQ, just like Pioneer's SVM 1000. Video SL provides two banks for effects, and the output of the first effect feeds into the next. Combining more than one effect makes it possible to create incredibly varied results. The new version makes it possible to save video effect combinations and settings to the audio or video track by clicking Save Effects under the deck. Moving over to the effects mode on the TTM mixer, the two push rotaries for either channel now select and scroll through effects. Push down to select one and twist to adjust the parameter. The joysticks toggle between the two effects banks up and down, while flicking them to the right toggles the effects on and off. And finally, to momentarily flash them on or off, flick it to the left. Video SL has a new offline player for previewing video files. Now you can create audio-visual combinations and try out video effects and save them without the hardware connected. VideoSL offers rock-solid performance with high-quality effects and transitions. The ability to use MIDI controllers and output to multiple video channels makes it a more professional option. It's incredibly easy to use, and there's an amazing online community for troubleshooting or just getting tips.
Well, what it does really excites me, the fact that it does it night after night. It's user-friendly enough for me to get my head around it, which is sounds like quite an easy order, but I'm easily confused. Yeah, reliable and portable.
Since our first review in DJ Mag, Serato fixed the three main gripes we had, which leaves very little to complain about. However, we'd like to see more control over the effects rather than just that one parameter. And it's a shame that the video EQ effects only works with a TTM mixer.
Well, we're just talking to Serato about changing the colour scheme on some things because I'm red-green colourblind. The problems I'm finding at the moment is when you were DJing with records, you'd have your set vaguely in BPM order. So you'd walk through it. But every time you played a tune, you'd take it out and put it on the side. Which A means you're not looking through tunes you've already played, and B, you know which tunes you've already played. Which sometimes, if you're playing night after night, it's like, did I play that tonight? Or was that last night? So, we wanted, but it does actually change colour once you've played it, but I can't see that, especially with the lights on. So, we're just talking to Serato about changing the colour scheme of how you know which tunes you played or not. And the other thing I wanted to talk to you about, actually, is the resistance on the crossfader. If the crossfade is interchangeable.
Get made a bit stronger. A bit
well, there's no resistance in it, because normally you kind of slide it in it. This, you kind of flick it and it goes
all the way over.
It goes miles.
This all-in-one masterpiece will have you painlessly mixing and scratching videos instantly. A complete system will fit in a regular backpack, making it incredibly portable, and it's now one of the most affordable pro VJ systems available.
You know, when we got together and first put video with the show, it was just kind of at the right time, and then, you know, DJs being as big as bands was at the right time, which I guess how anything happens and takes off. You know? And this product is, you know, the right thing at the right time.